So guys, today I've just got to head down the shop to get some fertilizer for my wife to plant those seedlings. But first of all, kia ora. So I'd like to shout out to the Worthless Welder and Anonymous for supporting the Stray Cat Cafe project with their Buy Me A Coffees. You both are legends. Thanks a lot, guys. Once again, guys, thanks a lot for your support in the Stray Cat Cafe project. And on the way there, I'd like to talk another topic on dating. So I think I might title this one Scooters and Mothercom. So in this video you'll get a little bit of Aussie culture and Japanese culture, so it's a two for one. So in Japan and elsewhere you'll find women with really bright dyed hair, and we used to call these scooters in Western Sydney when I was growing up. And the reason why is because they're a lot of fun to ride, but you just don't want your family and friends to know that that you've got one. So that's why they're called scooters. So anyway, there's plenty of scooters in Japan, and I'll try and tell you how to spot them. So this is not to be confused with a different cultural phenomenon in Japan. Basically, when kids go to school, they have very strict dress codes, even down to how they have their hair and everything like this. So what happens when they graduate is everybody goes to the hairdressers, or when I say everybody, a lot of people go to the hairdressers, and they go and get the wackiest hairdo they can imagine. It's sort of a stress relief, little bit rebellion type thing. So a lot of these girls, they get all these red, blue, pink, yellow, whatever, dyed hairdos. And a lot of them never go back to their original color. And these are what we call the scooters back in Australia when I was growing up. So there is a term in Japan, it doesn't cover every aspect of this, but they're called gyaru, and it's sort of an English take on the word girl. And these girls are out there, these women are out there, and really wacky hairdos, wacky fashions, and they never mature, they never stop it, even up until their 30s, 40s, 50s. And these ladies are dangerous, and you don't want to go and marry these types. As I said, most will go through this little getting their hair done, different color phase, just last 6 months sort of after they finish school. But these colored hair girls in Japan, they're absolutely wild. So I had a friend who came over from Italy, a young guy, and he did his last year of high school. And he went back to Italy, and he's now in Brazil at the moment. And I taught him how to drive in my K truck, and he used to help me out a lot in my veggie patches and around the house. And he came over on a program, like a scholarship program, and all the foreigners that came over were around 17, around his age, and they had to sign a declaration that they would never have a girlfriend and they're just here to study and all this sort of stuff. So all their homestay families were sort of like their police. And Simon got me in a bit of trouble actually with somebody in the village, and they still don't believe me. But anyway, he used to go out on a Friday or Saturday night, and he used to tell his homestay family that he's just going around to my place. And because they know who I am, they let him out, so on the Friday, Saturday. But and I had no idea about this. He didn't tell me about it. And he was out on the town and chasing women and stuff like that. So he was a real party animal and pickup artist. Really, really nice guy, perfect Japanese, and a good looking young man as well. So he was quite successful with the ladies. And one time I was giving him a driving lesson, and he showed me a picture of this Gyaru type girl. And he said that she was 25, and she had super bright hair. And I said, look, man, you've got to be really careful. And he was totally enamored with this girl. And I said, look, there's a reason why they've got the red hair. And he says, why? I said, because they're scooters. And he says, what's a scooter? And I said, you know, there might be a lot of fun, you know, but just don't let your family and friends know that you ride one. So anyway, he was totally enamored with this girl, and I told him just to be really careful, and he sort of didn't believe me. He must have thought I'm just a silly old man or something. And about a month later, this woman turned his life upside down, and he was having a bit of a whinge and a moan and whatever about it. I said, look, I warned you. And I said to him, there's a reason why dangerous animals are always red in nature. And it's because they're dangerous. 99% of the time, if they're red, they're dangerous. And there's a reason. So he was having a great time in Japan and enjoying himself and studying and things like that. And his life just turned into a complete drama. This is probably common in every country, and it's true here, but it's only true for the ones that haven't dropped their hair dye after they left school. So I got the call from his homestay family, and this lady was angry, man. And I didn't get the full story because I just put her onto my wife, you know, because you could just see the steam coming out of the ears over the phone. So he must have come home drunk and probably had spew all over him or something from a heavy night. And he's told her that he's got out with me. And I've been at home with my wife the whole time, obviously. And she believed him and not me. So so he's denied that he's got out. On the town, he's still stuck to his story that he was at my house, see? So he wouldn't get kicked out and sent home. So he had to stick to his story, you know. Like, obviously he smelt of alcohol and it spew all over him or something. But they had no proof, sort of thing. So the homestay family couldn't do anything. So. To this day, she still believes that he went to my house and got drunk. That's what I think anyway. So I see her around a couple of times, and I get that sort of you naughty boy sort of look towards me, which I had nothing to do with. But I had to deny it, obviously, because it didn't happen first, and I wasn't informed as well, so I'm not a snitch or anything. But that's how he was able to stay in Japan. Otherwise, she would have for sure kicked him out. But that's what happens when you get involved with these redhead guys, redhead girls, and he learned his lesson the hard way. So I called him up and I said, you know, you're in a world of hurt. And he says, oh, they can't do anything because they got no proof. So. Anyway, he had to sign that declaration, and he also the signing that he couldn't smoke tobacco and drink and stuff like that. So he broke all those free rules the whole time he was here. So the next one for marriage and dating advice is they've got a term here in Japan, and it's called mother comp, and it stands for mother complex. So this is normally used for men. So for you ladies, there's a term called mother comp, and they're basically like mummy's boys, and there are a lot of guys that are still like well attached to their mothers, even as adults into their 50s and 60s, you know. It's a really strange phenomenon, but there's a lot of it here in Japan, and that's why they got a term for it. Whenever there's a term for something, it means it's quite common. So, and these guys are looked down on, and they've also got like another term, like herbivore, and they sort of lump all these sort of guys into the same sort of bracket. So there's a lot of guys that haven't matured either. That also applies for women. If you notice you're dating a Japanese lady and she's always calling her mother and she's always asking for advice from her mother, and they may even outwardly say, you know, I'm really close to my mother and we talk about everything and we share everything, these are red flags. You've got to run like the wind, because the mother-in-law will be controlling every single decision in your marriage, and it won't be direct, but your wife will be basically telling you how things are going to be, and this is going to be influenced by her mother, so you might as well be married to her mother. So if you find a lady that's just way too close to her mother, that's never a good thing. And before heading out this morning, I know about the male thing with the mother con, and I asked my wife, is there a word for the female type, which is this sort of type? And there is a word, but she couldn't recall it. So if anyone knows, just chuck it in the comments. But that is a thing too. So these gyaru types, I've had a couple in the cafe, and I had an issue with one actually, and this gyaru type, really crazy fashion, five different colours in her hair, and she had platform shoes, or they're sort of like high heels, but it's the whole shoe, and she was like 5 metres off the ground. That's how high these heels were. Really big, it's like she's standing on stilts. And she came into the cafe, and as she was walking, she's wobbling all over the place, and she was carrying a baby. And she wanted to go upstairs and eat. So she got this one-year-old baby or something in her arms. She can barely walk herself, and she wants to go upstairs. And I just told her, no, if you want to eat, just stay downstairs. And she didn't like it straight away, like, no, I'm going to go upstairs. I said, well, you know, either you eat downstairs or go. That's what I told her. And anyway, she stayed downstairs and ate, and hasn't come back. That's my rules. I couldn't live with myself if she walked up the stairs with the baby and fell over and the baby got injured. But these are the type of women that are in Japan. They're even married with kids. They're immature, they've still got their crazy hairdos and their crazy fashions, and they do stupid stuff like that. Imagine being married to one of these ladies, and that's your child, and she's walking around in stilts carrying your kid. This is what you're going to have to put up with if you marry these types. And there's a lot of them, especially in cities. You'll find that a lot of Japanese culture that you see on the YouTube and on the internet in general are all these sort of Harajuku type girls, and they got, you know, the cutesy fashions and the anime culture and all that sort of stuff. This is what a lot of young Westerners are drawn to, this sort of thing. And it's just not good as a long-term marriage proposition here. A lot of the sensible guys go nowhere near them. for good reason. You just see the tragedies that unfold. And what happens is if you marry these type of women and it goes sour and you've got kids, it's very difficult to get to see your kids in Japan, because the custody usually goes to the mother, unless it could be proven that they're unfit or something like that. So it's just not a good long-term proposition. And if you were a foreigner, it'd be even more difficult. So you might have a good time and lots of fun the first 2, 3, 4, 5 years, but it's just going to go pear-shaped most of the time. Just because someone's sort of dressed like that, it's not necessarily 100% that's going to happen, but the percentages are just so against you that it's not even worth the risk. So it's funny that a lot of popular culture that you see on the internet about any country, and Japan is no exception, it's not really healthy from a family point of view. Imagine being a person in Japan and watching all the rock and roll culture from the West and things like that, and all the rock chicks and whatever. They're not really the type of people that if you had a son, you'd advise to marry at all. So guys, I'm back home, and just remember, stay away from the scooters. And as always, hope you like the video.
Let's go back home.